Hey everybody, this is Matt from endsickness.org. Just giving you a summary here on mast cells and how they affect autoimmune disease. It's going to be a brief video to give you a crash course on mast cells and why this matters to you if you're struggling with an autoimmune condition. So, what are mast cells? Mast cells are a type of white blood cell known as an effector cell. What they do is they send out inflammatory mediators like cytokines, chemokines, histamine, that influence other immune cells and tell them what duties to perform in essence. So the mast cells are, I guess you want to say, the head honcho, and they're telling all their people or other immune cells what to do. So they're the guy in charge. So that's what makes them the ideal therapeutic target for someone suffering from autoimmune conditions. So where are mast cells located? They're located in the intestinal system, skin, lungs, nerves, sinuses, anywhere that the body is exposed to outside bacteria or invasions per se. Intestines, lungs, sinuses seem to be the three areas that are the most importance with autoimmune people. Autoimmune disease typically originates from some bacterial imbalance, not only in the region near the head, but also in the stomach. Once both of them are out of balance, then you got the symptoms, all hell breaks loose per se. So mast cells, once again, they're the effector cells. They're the ones that send out the inflammatory chemicals. They're responsible for creating the majority of symptoms of autoimmune disease. They send out cytokines, chemokines, histamine, and that influences the other immune cells in essence. So how do they affect autoimmune systems? They regulate allergy response. Obviously, people with autoimmune symptoms have a lot of hidden allergies and known allergies. This is not just environmental allergies. This could be environmental allergies to mold. It could be allergies to blueberries. It could be allergies to peanut butter. It could be allergies to various things that aren't anaphylactic-like reactions, but they're low-grade histamine-inducing sensitivities that perpetuate this mast cell response. Why do these things happen? Because these particular proteins in these foods are not broken down properly in a gut that's compromised in an autoimmune patient, and that protein leaks into the gut through the leaky, or at least into the blood through the leaky gut. That protein is then noticed by the immune system. The immune system is able to catalog that protein through molecular pattern recognition and remember that particular food as being a particular offender. It catalogs it like it's a pathogen. So when you got that food, it enters again into the body. The immune system immediately reacts like it's a pathogen entering, when in fact it was just a food that leaked into the bloodstream. So that's what people were dealing with leaky gut. Quick summary. Also, mast cells affect innate adaptive immunity. That's your ability to fight off infections that come in. That's your ability to generate an immune response when they're already present. If both of those are compromised, and guess what? You're going to be living in an infected type of situation there. Autoimmunity and inflammation, they're also responsible for. They will initiate autoimmune type reactions with other cells that eat away at connective tissue, etc., like macrophages. Inflammation, they'll secrete histamine and other inflammatory chemicals to initiate inflammation. They control histamine levels for the most part. Histamine is released primarily from mast cells, and that's how allergy response is dictated from the amount of histamine in the blood. So mast cells are the therapeutic target in essence. How do you modulate mast cells? Do that through the use of herbs, phytonutrients. You can do that through stress-reducing activities, but primarily through the use of herbs that are known to either attenuate a current allergy response or modulate a mast cell response. There are certain herbs that block allergy response or certain herbs that stop allergy response from continuing when it's already occurring. There are certain herbs that stop anaphylactic response. There are certain herbs that modulate the allergy response in general, so you just respond to the things you should. I mean, there's lots of various options. You know, one that comes to mind is a phytonutrient biosilane from Skullcap, but there's about 120 plus that modulate mast cell activity that I found from my research. So number four, are there any other immune cells that are involved with autoimmune diseases? Yes, you got the regulatory T cell imbalance also. Regulatory T cells typically are low in relation to T helper cells. This creates a situation where your T helper cells are start to overreact to nearly everything that's coming in. So it's important to balance the regulatory T cells. You could do that through various types of phytonutrients. Again, biosilane from Skullcap is one that also affects regulatory T cells. German chamomile, the list goes on. There's several. I said there's about 120 of them. So you got the macrophages and you got the regulatory T cells. Macrophages are responsible for initiating inflammation and in the connective tissue, and damage to the connective tissue can damage to certain organs in response to autoimmune conditions. So you may, if you've got damage like thyroid issues, you have certain types of issues where the body is eating away at itself, the macrophages may be involved. Regulatory T cells are typically involved at the same time when mast cells are. They're typically out of balance. You can regulate, you can modulate your regulatory T cell balance through various herbs. So, you know, to really summarize, the therapeutic target of autoimmune disease is the mast cells. You could look up tons of studies and see this. Type in mast cell autoimmune disease study. You'll see various studies. You can read through it and see that mast cells are the therapeutic target because they control the activity of the various immune cells, and those immune cells are creating localized inflammation. The localized inflammation is what drives the autoimmune symptoms to appear within you. So if you can control the localized inflammation, the systemic inflammation, guess what? You're controlling the majority of your symptoms. You could still have an infection, but if you're suppressing inflammation, the infection is not going to be an active state. It's going to be in a state of dormancy. It's going to be a state where it's not replicating because it uses its ability to determine how much inflammatory presence exists in the environment to know if it's a proper time to replicate, to perform something called chemotaxis, where, you know, the spread throughout the body of different parts and create pockets, etc. So key points being, mast cells are the therapeutic target. If you target anything else or you put anything in your body that is not modulating mast cells when you're trying to recover from autoimmune disease, you are defeating your own self. All right, everything in my experience that has helped me to recover from autoimmune disease also modulated mast cell activity. So that is hopefully very helpful for you. Most of it, I was going down a rabbit hole for 15 years trying to fight infection, trying to detox heavy metals, trying to do everything you could ever think of, remove this, that from my diet. But until I focused all my attempts on modulating mast cells, reducing histamine level, reducing inflammation, I couldn't even get to the infection that was causing the issue in the first place. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this brief video on mast cells. There's going to be plenty more, and please subscribe.